Said my gastrointestinal tract right before a big commercial audition. Oh no, please come on, not today. But like a toddler that just discovered its autonomy, it kept demanding my attention. Me, 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 me. I stood outside the casting building and tried to quell the bubbling in my bowels with deep breaths. Oh, but I had the butterflies and the cauldron was about to burst. If this had been a commercial for, say, a remedy for an overactive amygdala, perhaps I could have passed it off as part of the audition process, but this was for a fast food commercial. I don't suppose screaming fits of diarrhea are big selling points for most restaurants. I would expect these sort of panic attacks from war veterans, but I was only auditioning for a commercial, for Christ's sake. It's not like the casting director was gonna lob a grenade at my head. But I needed the money, and I was a wreck over accepting an audition for a fast food joint. I just couldn't see myself promoting meat convincingly. I didn't need it or support it, so my conscience said no, but my bank account said yes. And my conscience, apparently, was located squarely in my gastrointestinal tract. So I walked into the office during a warm LA day on a Monday morning, and it was a clean, modern office with minimal decoration. A smattering of coloring appeared amongst the faux plants, and each corner, it was contemporary with high ceilings and exposed beams. Lovely on one hand, but the chairs were hard, utilitarian numbers, the kind that screamed, "Do your audition, and then get the hell out!" I sat down in one of the seats next to six other auditioning actors, and I begin to study my script when butterflies begin, and they are assault again on my gastrointestinal tract. They were huge, mutant butterflies that dispatched from the same sewers as the Ninja Turtles. They were large butterflies with yellow fetid fangs. You wouldn't find them in arboretums. Oh, no, no, no. These monsters lived in the literal bowels of hell. I tried to quash their assault, but they ravaged my insides until I had to bolt to the nearest bathroom down the hall. This, dear listener, is intermission time. Go check your Facebook page for the fifth time. Hum loudly. Just give me 5 minutes. Doesn't the dog need a walk? I think I hear the baby crying. Or maybe that's just the sound of my own whimpering. After exercising the butterflies from my body, I flushed them away to the sewers from whence they came, only to have them return their rancid effluvium gifts to the particles in the bathroom air. In other words, it stank. No, 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 no. My mind screamed, damn evil butterflies, how would I ever learn to peacefully coexist with the creatures? Truce, I begged, but the damage was already done. I pulled out my travel-sized baby powder from my bag, and I tried to freshen up the bowl. I sprayed the strong strawberry air freshener provided, but to no avail. Now it just smelled like a baby who'd been pooping strawberries. In defeat, I retreated back to the lobby to wait my turn to audition. I sat there for about 30 seconds more, and then the casting director entered the lobby. "What's that smell?" she inquired of her assistant. Oh no, ooh, the air conditioner had pulled the odor through the bathroom vent and out into the lobby. The casting director had noticed. Who did that? She didn't make any direct accusations, but I know she had pinpointed that the stench had emanated from down the hall and it was one of the actors in her lobby that was guilty party. But I wasn't about to volunteer my guilt. By now, everyone's eyes twitched and nostrils involuntarily clamped shut. Oh, I was mortified. I feared one of the other auditioning actors saw me exit the bathroom. Oh, they'll tell on me. I know it. Don't hire her, they'll say. If she'll destroy the entire plumbing system in your office, think what she'll do on set. Bastards, saboteurs, but what can I do? Make the, whoever smelt it, dealt it. accusation. It was the casting director's discovery, and I couldn't accuse her. It wasn't quite the discovery I anticipated for my career at all. Instead, I chose to ignore the one-ton pink gorilla dry-humping the three-legged elephant in the room, or mix cliched metaphors to that effect. I went about my business rehearsing in my head as if there were no life-choking odor emanating from the bathroom down the hall. The casting director's accusations threatened to awaken the butterflies again, but I fought my nervousness as best I could. Another trip to the bathroom would only reveal me as the guilty party. I continued to ignore the odor as the other actors writhed and contorted in pain. But ignoring it, only made me look like the guilty party. I nearly blurted out, ever since the bomb went off during my tour of duty in the Gulf War, I haven't been able to smell a thing. It blew my olfactory bulbs clear out of my nose. Lucky me, eh? But that sort of admission would qualify as offering too much information. Anyone with 5 minutes of experience watching court TV knew that when I was guilty. Oh, please call me next. McPherson, the assistant said. Yes, I was next. Oh, crap. Do I make eye contact with the casting director now or not? I read somewhere that liars often overcompensate by making too much eye contact, that they try to gauge whether you're believing their tall tales or not. So I entered the room and I introduced myself to her and stared directly into her eyes. Hi, I'm Devon. Nice to meet you. Great, now I look like a sociopathic serial killer. Best not to look at her at all. Hi, I'm Devon. And it's nice to meet you. So I averted my eyes, but now I must have looked autistic. I was screwed. On top of that, I was supposed to improvise eating a burger, something I hadn't done in 20 years. I love this big, juicy burger. From a terrified cow pumped full of antibiotics and growth hormones and dragged across the slaughterhouse floor with a broken leg to the killing floor, where, if lucky, is actually brutally rendered unconscious with a stun gun before being hung from a meat hook. But not always. And the factory farming is doing wonders for the environment, too. Despite my internal monologue, I did try to sound sincere. But sometimes, even when I was genuinely sincere, I could sound sarcastic. So that day, I thought I must have at least come off as smarmy or perhaps distressed, which again is not a big selling point for most restaurants. I did the best job I could in the audition, given the circumstances, and then hauled ass out of there. I didn't get the job. I don't know if it was the vile stench in the room that cost me the job, but I wasn't taking any chances. I wouldn't eat for 2 days prior to my next audition. Maybe then I'd only get the dry heaves and pass out from low blood sugar.